Hey everybody, Brooks here, First Baptist Church of the Islands. Hope you're having a great day today, and thank you for taking time to join me for today's 5-4-5. So on Sunday mornings for a few weeks now, we've been in the series called Bearing Fruit. And in this series, we're looking at a passage of Scripture in Galatians chapter 5 that talks about what Paul describes as the fruit of the Spirit. It's all these qualities that reflect Jesus, nine of them to be specific. And one of them that we looked at yesterday was the quality of peace. Now, throughout this whole series, what we've been reminded of is that we can't produce these qualities in our own strength, that we have to abide in Christ. We have to walk in the Spirit and let Him produce those qualities through us. And so when it comes to the topic of peace, this morning I wanted to kind of go down a road that I didn't go down yesterday, and that is in regards to peace between us and other people. Yes, peace on the inside flows out of our peace with God, but also God calls us to be at peace with other people. In fact, listen to what it says here. I love this passage of Scripture in the book of Romans chapter 12. It's in verse 18. It says, "If possible, so far as it depends on you, be at peace with all men." If possible, right? It's almost as though God understands that peace between people is a two-way street. You probably have experience, right, with those instances in your life where you tried to be at peace with somebody and they wouldn't have any part of it. Or maybe somebody else tried to make peace with you and you were at a place where you were just bitter or you were angry or you were just so hurt that you couldn't extend forgiveness. You couldn't accept their offer of peace. God understands that. But what He calls us to, especially as followers of Jesus, is that as much as it depends on us, as best we can, the way Paul describes it here in verse 18, so far as it depends on you, be at peace with all men. That's what God calls us to, right? And so maybe in your marriage or maybe in a relationship with a coworker or a relationship with a friend or someone else, maybe there's some strain there for you. Maybe it's not always easy to have peace in some certain relationships for you. But what God wants is that you can lay your head down at night, every night, with that clear conscience and a peace in your heart too, that really you've tried your best to be at peace with those around you. Maybe that means sometimes saying I'm sorry, right? And literally owning our part of the hurt that sometimes comes in other people's lives. There's nothing wrong with admitting that and saying I'm sorry. It doesn't make you less of a person. In fact, if we're unwilling to ask forgiveness, sometimes it just shows that we're insecure, right? We should be secure in God's forgiveness of us and who we are in Christ to be able to own our mistakes. And sometimes that means saying I'm sorry. Sometimes it means taking a step into the conflict and initiating that first step, writing that letter, maybe making that phone call and beginning the conversation that says, hey, let's work this out. Let's resolve our differences. And if they're not willing, at least you have a clear conscience that you tried, just like Romans tells us to. And then another aspect of this too, let's be honest, is to not take steps to stir up strife. A lot of times, if we're not careful, we can kind of, you know, be back in grade school again and be that person who wants to pick at someone else or sort of stir the pot a little bit. Sometimes that's on social media. We like to put that comment out there. It feels like it's safe, but if we develop that kind of a, you know, pattern on social media, we're probably going to be that way person to person, face to face as well. So, you know, don't stir up strife. Don't be a person who's known for creating conflict. Be known for one who steps into the conflict to create peace. Blessed are the peacemakers, Jesus would say in the Sermon on the Mount. So I don't know how this applies to you. It probably does. It applies to every one of us. And if it doesn't now, it will at some point. So just keep that passage in mind, Romans 12:18. As far as it depends on you, be at peace with all people. Press in close to Jesus. Let Him cultivate that quality through your life as you deal with those who are sometimes closest to you. Hey, hope you have a great day today. God bless you.